And so we'll go ahead, it's 4:15, we'll go ahead and get started with work session, and we'll start off, Bijan's gonna lead us in prayer.
Let's pray. Lord, we thank you for this day, we thank you for every blessing day that you give us, Lord. We thank you for this town, we thank you for the government that we have. Lord, help us to do a right thing for the citizens of this town and the decision we make for this town, Lord. It's pleasing you, and with Jesus' name, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Attention, salute, pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Okay, we'll go ahead and get started. Mr. Tina Pike, you'll come up.
Hello again.
Hey.
I thank y'all for allowing me to come before you once again. The reason why I'm here is to make my interruption. This is our sixth year, and that means a lot, that Addicts for Christ has existed that long and that we are reaching so many people. And this is just our flyer that I'll let y'all keep and pass around if you want to. This is our sponsorship package. Our sponsors, like when you sponsor, what you're doing is you're helping us put on the event, because it costs so much money for the sound system, for the musicians, and for everybody that comes. Any money left over after we pay for the event goes to send somebody to drug rehab. I think last year we had sent like 220-something people to rehab. We're at 300. We now have three placement directors, one in Chattanooga, one in Jackson County, and myself in DeKalb County. As of this past year, Jackson County Court referral is working with us. DeKalb County Court referral is now working with us. We have attorneys calling us, asking us to place their client. We are having a real hard time right now placing women because they're all full. And I think any of the police officers could tell you this here. The problem's getting worse. There's more and more drugs coming in. They're new drugs. There's something we never heard about. There's something we've never seen. And it's becoming, and it's going to get worse, like I said. It's becoming hard to place people because they're all full. But we have a list, and anyone in our community that needs help, that comes to us, that wants help, they're going to get the help. They just may have to wait. Unfortunately, some of them can't wait. A young man came to me, begged to be put somewhere that day. Well, now he no longer is with us. He told me if I didn't find him a place, he wouldn't live. Well, he was telling the truth. He took his life that night. That is a burden on me. And to be able to tell somebody that we cannot send them because we don't have the funds or because we can't find a bed hurts. I know that y'all help us every year. You help sponsor this. And that's what I'm asking for, is you to financially help us put this on so that people can be aware and learn that we're here, that there's help, that there's restoration, and that we allow God to move in Addicts for Christ. It's not us, it's God doing what he does through us. But it's more than that. I want to ask you for more than sponsorship. You are all voted in by the citizens of this town. I ask you to support us. Come. Come to Meth Mountain Interruption. Tell the people of Rainsville about it. The people of DeKalb County, tell them about it. There's 93% of homes in America has struggled with addiction, whether it be through a friend or a family member. We just want to bring awareness that we're here. There's going to be a lot of other rehab facilities going to be there that day, so they can see how much help there really is out there. Because an addict, and me being an ex-addict, I know, we feel like all alone, there's nobody there, nobody's going to help us. We're just alone, but we isolate ourselves as an addict, and that's what addicts do. But we just want to bring awareness, and we ask y'all to be the examples to the citizens and get involved and show that you support what we do. I know the chief has called me himself, and I talked with people that have been in jail here. I've gotten people out of jail. Last week we sent 3 people to rehab. We're growing so much, and we're so thankful for that. And we would appreciate any support y'all can give us, okay?
What did we do last year? $500.
Y'all got any questions?
Thank you for what you do.
My blessing.
Thank you.
Well, I think y'all already got a lot of the information, my suggestions about improving Dilbeck Road, but I don't know the reason or who was responsible for the uneven width of the road from the bridge back towards 75 versus the other side. And I'm certain, well, I can't say I'm certain, but if not, y'all put down the checker to see how many vehicles travel past on that side of the 75 side of Dilbeck Road versus the other side where the pavement is so wide. I'm certain you'll find there's much more that come off 75 on the Dilbeck, where it comes off Marshall Road onto it. And I'd like to have an explanation of why the difference in that was in width. I measured it on this, and I'm wrong where this was put down, the 3+ feet on the width, difference in width. I did measure that, and I measured from the outside the white stripe to the other side, the outer portion, and it was 3 foot in. I said, hey, I better go back and check. So I took 5 measurements on each side, outside pavement to outside pavement, and it averaged 2.25 feet, a little better, wider on the RTI side, and I just don't understand it. And the weight limit on the bridge, everything's already is written down here. You know, the weight limit on the bridge I'm not wanting a new bridge, but everything on the other side, we're residential over there, and children, a lot of children in the neighborhood. And anyway, the bridge, I measured it, it's 21, a little better than 21 foot wide outside. The outside, what can pass on it, it's wider than the pavement on our side. And I just don't know, and speeds, I know there have been some warnings and complaints about the speed of the traffic over through there, and I'm sure it may slow down, but I mean, if we put up signs, it looks like to me they should be enforced, speed limits. And I mean, I suggest you can put the word out, or it may go out from here if y'all declare it. But hey, there's nothing wrong with having, since our road is more narrow on our side, to have and the children too, it needs slowing down for passenger vehicles. And the 18-wheeler stuff, they've been 4 different trucks in the last 2 years. I don't know if their GPSs is what the drivers told me, that have buried their trucks turning around in front of where I did have my chicken farms in operation. But I mean, that their GPS, they say they get a glitch in the direction there, and it messes them up. Signs need to be placed up on 75, directing which way Max Pack as well as Blue Steel is. Because they turn off that, there's transfer trucks with steel on it many, many times a week that come by my house.
understand it, and I'd like to say it, I'd like to have a written explanation, or y'all verbally give it to me, and I don't mean tonight, but I'm talking about in the next council meeting, us discuss everything. And like I was talking about, it'd be much cheaper on these recommendations for, and the safety would be there, about the four-way stop up on 75. Now, I was turning off from Rainsville coming in, there was a 18-wheeler headed north on 75, and was making the left-hand turn into the Max Pack Yard, Field West. And anyway, something would happen if there was a four-way stop there. Something, there would have to be some widening of the road turning in on Dilbeck West, because I could see that him turning in, that vehicle would have to back up. And if they were really a jam pack like that intersection is sometimes, there'd be cars, vehicles behind it, and it would cause some big problems. So he needs to have an area where he could turn in. And the same way over on Marshall Road, if they had that three-way stop there, trucks coming from RTI or wherever out of industrial could go north on Marshall, north on 75 via Marshall, or go south back to 35. And a three-way stop there with a hill being on the heading toward Marshall off Fieldback Road there, it's dangerous about a truck pulling out and trying to make that turn, because he's going to be out in the other lane about somebody popping that hill. And that way, he'll get his turn, get right where he needs to be, can back up the three-way stop a little further on the vehicle on Marshall Road going north. And, if there's any, if you don't agree or can work with these suggestions, I would like to just have a reasonable explanation why not. And it's not, we sure don't need to be spending money that we ain't got. And getting grants ain't, where does the grant money come from?
Here.
I know.
Yeah.
And that's not, it's got to be paid back. These days we're living in, it ain't.
So you want me to answer some of those questions?
Not now. Now if you want to. Yeah, if we got time,
I'll take a couple minutes and we'll talk about some of them. Yeah, well, to start with, the Highway 35 part, we don't have any control of. If you want a four-way stop there or a red light there, it has to go to the state. It has to go to John Cooper at the state.
You mean 75,
man. I meant 75, yes. Yeah. 75. So that's not us right there. Now Dilbeck is ours, both directions. The reason that the width of the road on the west end of it from the bridge is back basically what it was. They try to put it back close to what it was because the underlayer is not, like the underneath it is not built up for it. Okay, because there's not supposed to be them trucks on there. We're trying to slow those trucks down and get them off of it. The reason that the other side was built up a little bit more is because RTI had changed their routing of their trucks coming in and going out. There's 80 trucks a day comes out of there, in and out every day. Okay, so we beefed up that side of Dilbeck and made the turn lane down there so they would have to go back out industrial. And that's why that was built like that, is to try to divert them, because they were getting into that hairpin turn back when the industrial couldn't make it. And that's why some of them come across the bridge. So we fixed all that to try to stop those trucks. And we'll push it with the police. We'll get them over there. We'll stop them from coming across on it. We'll do what we can to do it.
Does the city have the authority to stop to control what crosses that bridge?
Yes, that's what I was talking about. We'll get the police over there.
We'll
stop that. Now, it's a weight limit. So if it's a tractor trailer that's not loaded, it may not be over the weight limit, because that's an 11-ton bridge on axles. If you go by the axles, and that's what it goes by.
I saw where the road was just recently redone with state funding, so Rodney, we'd have to check with them too, because it may be an alternate route to get, how we got some of that money, in case something was, there's a bad record, so we'd have to run that through the state, because we got state money to help do that road, but the state don't have.
State money that you don't have to pay back?
No, we don't have to pay back.
It's free.
I don't think he makes.
I don't think he makes.
Yeah, I don't think he makes free.
I don't know.
Don't be.
The signs.
Why would you say the state about, oh, an actual city road?
Well, it's just kinda like the ultimate ones that, other side.
What do you say to the man's name in the state that's in charge of 75?
Well, all the state roads, the head guy with the state is John Cooper. Now, there's a local person around here.
What's his name?
I don't know who it is.
Curtis Love.
Curtis Love.
Curtis Love.
Yeah, he would be more right here.
Not a sign thing, but.
Where's he, office?
No, you could, and I agree with you on those signs for Max Pack and all those, you know, Blush Go. I think there will be signs up there on the road.
I mean.
Helping direct them, because there's people gets lost all the time on that.
Do we have to apply for a permit to do that? Wouldn't it be no different than, since it's on the state highway being on?
Yes.
Yeah, it'd have to be.
We can look into that.
You'll have to get the engineer to look into that.
Yeah, it has to be permitted. Everything goes along that highway has to be permitted.
Mr. Appleton, for your information, I've been working on, I guess about 8 years now, for that hilltop, what is more really traffic than that dead vehicles.
Right.
I have not been success any at all. Two times, the traffic engineer from the state come out there and they set the camera, and they did the traffic cam, and it says not feasible to put stop sign or was asking for traffic light, you know, red light, but they say it's not feasible.
Well, I know.
There was even petitions, a couple of petitions.
You know, like down at going to Coleman, Smith's Crossroad that way. I mean, those.
They said something like you're looking up for eggs or.
You know, I really believe it. It would be more pleasant on all parties involved.
Yeah.
But.
We'll let our engineer look at this recommendation that you have. Maybe he come up with some explanation why this and why that. As far as 75, I tell you, well, Mayor told you today, it's not gonna happen.
Yeah.
I mean, you're pretty slow, I've heard the name.
And it should have helped some, Rodney, with that turn lane over at that substation, to help get some of those trucks back out, because they were having a hard time, and there's someone coming across.
You know, if they're going out using that, going toward Marshall.
Yeah.
They still, they'd be a three-way stop for that.
They're not supposed to be going towards Marshall either, because Marshall is not rated for that. I mean, it's rated for it probably, but that hill and everything, they're supposed to, they got information over there that tells them they're supposed to go out that other way through industrial.
I believe last time we paid it, they put the sign up, says no through traffic truck.
It says, I went past the picture today.
The only trucks have to go through is the local, like chicken trucks or whatever.
Delivery.
Yeah.
So it is signed up.
And, you know, there'll be some of those FedEx and some of those.
It's delivery, you know, 80 trucks, you can use for delivery.
Yeah.
Commercial truck.
We'll get the.
But we will look at this, and we'll get back where you can come see me or something, we'll sit down and talk about all this.
And we'll get the police out there to slow some of that traffic down too.
I mean, if the word gets out, you're going to, you mean what you say, hey, give everybody one warning ticket and let them know that if you get stopped again, it's gonna cost you. And it ain't no speed trailer, nothing, but just let them know.
Just trying to make it safe.
I think at one time we did put that little speed trailer up, didn't we, Weedman?
Yes, sir.
Everything.
It was up there, yeah.
Just put it back up.
When people coming up the hill heading towards 75, they round the curve and then they start braking.
See that?
Yeah.
We'll get some of them out there.
Yeah.
Get you.
Where?
You wasn't talking about me, was you? Because when I seen it, I broke.
There you go.
Well, okay.
That's just natural to do that, I think.
That's what I was wanting to hear about.
Thank you, Rod.
Y'all check, hey, that Curtis Lowe, are you gonna speak with him?
No.
No.
You've been there.
I'll.
Yeah.
I know what he's understanding, so.
Real good, thank you.
Thank you, Rod.
Okay, Marston, you have anything? And it's going okay?
Going great.
Yeah?
Yeah, it is.
So how many people's going through that?
Oh, hey, I think that's tall, aren't they?
They used to be a bunch, so I hadn't talked to them, so.
I think they're saying something about moving one, I don't know if he's moving him or what, but it's time to put the one in the control lane. I mean, I don't know if he's gonna take one away from here or just move, you know, put a separate one down there.
Find out how many transactions we're doing, like a year or a month or something, just kinda give us an idea.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yes, a quarterly report, anyway.
Okay, Derek?
Only thing I really don't have anything, I don't spend no money.
Good.
I know that October's coming up, fire prevention month, so I'll be bringing that up here probably next month. I think last year we gave $1,500 to that to help promote fire prevention for October. So here pretty soon I'll be putting that on the table again. Our new guys, Blizzard and Phillips, they're in EMT school right now, they're doing well. Justin Harper, he passes advanced EMT class, so we have another advanced EMT guy on our team. So that's really, really, really a good thing to have, is a lot of these guys, if we get them all advanced EMTs. That's kind of what we're gonna do. Luke, our police guy, he's in academy, doing well. Other than that, I mean, everything's pretty much going smooth. We have, how many kids now? Is it 8 kids? We've got the program going with the tech school. We have 8 kids involved right now with the fire department. Their motor's been over there teaching them. Chief's been popping in and out, making sure everything's going smooth. So what you guys are doing is awesome, and we appreciate it. I know the county school system appreciates it too. Again, this is the first time that anybody's done this in the county, so kind of want to brag on you guys. But other than that, that's really all I've got. I just want to brag on them.
Okay. Rick?
Mayor, we got one more cover that we're going to pave down on Parker. We got the cover in. Mr. Boozer's supposed to do the head walls starting this week, maybe. That's the last one we're going to try to do this year. Due to the weather coming up, we've spent a lot of money on that this year as well. But I've said in the past, you know, we're talking about roads coming apart, covers coming apart. It's very crucial to have our citizens get safe road and covers to travel on. The bridges and everything down George Wallace. You and I talked about that earlier, and Councilman Freeman. I know they got all that pulled. We talked about the strength of it. It's got to be lifted up to finish it up, to get that plate under there where it will be back in code the way it should be. So hopefully within the next, 3 or 4 weeks or so?
Yeah, probably 2 to 4 weeks, at least probably 4. It's probably going to be 4 weeks.
Yeah.
By the time everything, the concrete gets cured out like it's supposed to, before we start putting the dent grade back against it to build it up for the road to set on, so it'll probably at least.
Pave it and all, or just?
Well, we won't pave it for a while.
It will be compaction on first.
We'll put the gravel mix over the top of it for a month or so. But then we'll pave it. But they'll be able to travel it maybe in about 4 weeks.
And that's the only one, like I said, that we light down there on Parker. And Mr. Boozer's going to go ahead and hopefully get started on that this week, because there's a lot of water that comes through that. I think there's like 30-inch tiles, makes two of them, a lot of drainage in that area. So we're going to go ahead and try to get that done in the next few days. That'll be the last one that we'll try to do this year, because
What's the cost?
Doing that.
What's the cost?
$3,400.
Look on your list.
Oh.
Do you want that?
Go and look at his list.
Oh, okay.
And that will put that back, and those was had to be installed at an angle, so they actually had to cut a little bit more of the asphalt out than normal. Some of them just go straight across, but this particular tile has to be done at an angle because of the way the creek and stuff comes down through there. So that's the reason it's $3,400, because they had to take out a little bit more of the asphalt and everything. But that's all I have, Mayor, to get that finished up.
I've had a lot of compliments on us doing that, really. I mean, a lot of people in town, they're receiving that upgrade.
Okay.
I'm paying for that.
Randy?
Yeah, Mayor, I guess we can give more of a praise report if you wanna go up by Field of Dreams and check out where Cornerstone. You know, so they got their goalposts and stuff up, their scoreboard and everything, getting ready for their first football game. I think they travel this week, and maybe next week's their first home game. Or tonight is the first.
They're home Friday night.
They're home Friday, and they travel tonight, but they play home Friday night. I seen someone on Facebook, they was going somewhere, I don't know what it was.
But their JV might be going somewhere, I don't know.
Yeah, so that'd be something new to see. Mm-hmm. And luckily, Plainview plays Thursday night, so we can go out and support Cornerstone on Friday and get us a, yep, see what, 5-man or 6-man football, what it looks like. So I'm kind of anxious to see that. Farmer's market's still wide open, doing great. I don't think we've had an empty spot yet, really, since we had the new building going.
Yeah, it's an issue. It's staying covered up.
That's right. It's a good issue. We're taking a look at that.
Had a lot of good comments about it.
And really, just kind of giving a praise report. Everything's going good on our end.
Okay, good. I think Brandon's going to bring it up when we get in the meeting, but I'll talk about this right here for just a second. We got a grant for you. I don't know, it seemed like a year ago now, because it takes forever to get all this stuff worked out. But ADECA, we got a grant for ADECA pertaining to a pumping station for the sewer, and that has all come around. We have bid it out the second time, done some changes on it. So now it's been okayed by the state through ADECA. I've been working with Caleb Lee from LAD Environmental, and the company that bid out this and got the low bid was a company called JetPel. So we had to go and check them out to make sure that their work is up to code and all that. But everything's good now, and so that will be moving forward. They will vote tonight to let me sign the contracts on it. And that total bid on that is $389,412.73. So that will get the pumping station at Highway 35 and Scott Street replaced, which we've been needing that to replace for a while. And so we got to piece this together and get some of this stuff done, you know, in case something big comes in one of these days. So that's another piece of the puzzle finished.
Looking for the future.
Yeah, that's right.
Stop kicking that can.
Anyway, Brandon, I think Brandon's gonna bring that up.
Yeah,
right
now,
so. All right, please, John.
Matt, if you remember when we bought that property beside the sewer plant, mm-hmm, to have access from Highway 75 to put the our garage, I think over there in that area, that 10 acres.
Put the shop
there. And we got 44 easement to tie into Highway 75. And I'm going to bring this up tonight and let Sam Phillip, which is our engineer, to submit a permit for the state to go ahead and get this ball rolling and hope we can build that road and tie into Highway 75. The only thing we have to do is get the permission from the two property owners on each side to give us more room for the radiuses. It's been done before, I don't think there's going to be any problem. So I bring this up tonight to let Sam go ahead and submit that.
Okay.
That's all I get. I think everything's okay with Tom Bevel. We just about done cleaning up the floors good, and she spent an extra hour to do more cleaning, I guess. The outside, we're gonna do a little bit of painting on the rails. I've got two people to give me a class on it. If they don't have to be done this year, I guess, man, if you got money, we'll do it this year. If you don't, we'll wait till next year.
Just give me the process first.
Yeah, and then the wall of China, it looks good.
It's cheap, though.
It's cheap. We've been there for $17,185.
Come out a little bit.
That's including the concrete and foundation and all that. And,
I told them that.
So that's what it costs, material.
Right.
The labor was done in-house. We have to pay.
The material was still $1,785.
Yes, sir.
Well, okay, flat. Then that brings the whole.
This is according to our city clerk.
We didn't vote. It was $750. I mean, you just said that young man.
Well, you know, and your ordinance, our councilman.
My ordinance.
This guy right here, that the ordinance at the city high, each one of us guys can spend that, and the mayor can also spend $1,000. I mean, we would discuss that here. No, we didn't vote on it, but we're all well aware of it, so. If he wants to spend $750, and he wants to spend $1,000, he wants to spend $750, we can all spend that without approval from you or anybody else.
But you went over $750.
That's the way the.
That's all I've got.
Can you count?
You went over $750.
$1,000, that's $750.
That's the part of the law.
You don't have to pay public.
That's right, so I'm gonna spend.
It's a maintenance program.
If you call Ross and say I'm gonna spend $750, mayor, I want you to spend $750.
So you want me to call you, the garbage truck fires up, and ask you about getting the garbage truck fixed? Is that what you're indicating, our council?
Well, why did they pass the resolution?
You need to ask them ones that voted on that, council.
Well, I'm set beside one, you're set beside one. Ask them.
Well, what'd y'all pass it for, boy?
It's about on the table.
It's on the table.
I know, we don't want it passed.
I tell you what, let's just pass that resolution, man, because this is some stupid thing they done in 2014.
You wanna just show it?
So you're telling the mayor he done something stupid?
When it been increased up to $1,000 or $1,500, whatever. I'm gonna bring that up now.
We'll ask to be in the resolution when you can bring it up now.
First of all, we'll talk about it. You're gonna have to look at the situation, like I said, about garbage trucks. Because when a garbage truck tires up, we're not gonna leave people's garbage sitting.
Well, ask the mayor why he voted for it.
Do you ever buy your truck tires?
Why he voted for it?
The what?
Ask the mayor why he voted for the resolution.
You're sitting beside it, then why don't you ask him?
Mayor, why did you vote for it?
When was that resolution?
It was,
You seem to know a lot about that resolution.
21-16, or 14.
2014.
I looked it up.
He was older than.
And I can't, you can't get to this.
We're gonna change that.
You can't pull resolution. It says oops, it says 404, not found oops, because that doesn't come up on website, but the heading of it says, mayor cannot spend $750 without council approval.
So what's?
That was the road, I mean, that's the resolution.
What's your point?
Because y'all spent, he just admitted y'all spent $785 to build that wall, and we didn't vote.
You wasn't here, sir. You was upset.
You did.
Okay, let's move on. We beat this to death in 2 weeks.
So you're telling me you voted?
Let's go.
Hey, chief. Everybody's gonna go to the fire department. Councilman Ross spoke about the guys in EMT class. It's going very well. Justin Harper, he said, didn't finish his EMT school.
And he's a, is his second or third one?
He's the third one.
Oh, yeah, because Sumter's one, he's one, and Cody's one.
Okay, so big one on every shift. Our goal is to get everybody to the advanced EMT level. I'll let Motor touch on the tech school deal, just a little bit of John Pierce. He is over there with the kids, and it's going very well.
Hey, thanks, chief.
Yes, thank you, chief. Really excited. We've got three from Valleyhead, three from Collinsville, one from Plainview, one from Savannah. It's a new experience for me to hear some of these stories from these kids and chief's talked before, I talk a lot, and I really figured most of the stuff that I say, don't really see it in, and I've got quite a bunch of questions and they're answering things that I honestly didn't expect them to remember or come back with, so I'm very proud of what we got. And we're still hoping to grow. Matter of fact, man, the chief talked today about possibly a lot of moving pieces and possibly being able to make some adjustments. We've got 8 right now, there's 2 in the second block and 6 in the third block. I would love to see us build that second block up a little bit so we can actually accomplish more hands-on, do some stuff. And I'm looking at ways, I think, well, we've got a plan to possibly be able to allow some other folks to come in second semester if they so mind to. So it's really good. I'm really tickled with the program. Thank y'all and the Board of Education, everybody, for your support behind us on this.
Well, the first year, it's good to have 8. I mean, this, the word's getting out. So next year, there's no telling how many we'll have. So, I mean, we're doing a great job, and that's awesome. We're getting a partner with the county to help out that. Hopefully, these children will grab hold of this and run it and make something for themselves. So y'all are impacting their lives and doing what y'all are doing.
Appreciate the support.
We appreciate it. We'll support you 100%. I will.
Yes, sir.
Comfortable, and the people are cleaning the sidewalks out around the building and doing some other cleanup. They sprayed the weeds that was growing up in the landscaping, and they're getting a little sick, but he says he's going to come back and spray them again, and that'll take care of all that.
Okay.
Thank you.
So is the floor still holding up good? Is it in the inside the tunnel? Is there
the wooden floor at some point in time needs to be either cleaned or refinished?
Don't he do that once a year?
No,
he did that once a year.
No, it's sometimes it's 4 or 5 years before it gets
done. It's been a long time since it's been refinished, but it has been cleaned a couple of times. I think the last time they cleaned it, they said that to clean it like that would not be feasible again.
Josh.
Everything's going well at the police department. Lee Yarbrough reported for his first day at the academy for 13 weeks, so wish him the best.
Yep. Sammy.
Hi, Brandon touched on some stuff at the Field of Dreams. We've got a lot going on up there. You have the farmer's market on Thursdays. Pee Wee football comes in Thursdays while we're doing the farmer's market, and this stays crowded till probably 8:30 or so. We still have softball tournaments scheduled every weekend. They don't make every weekend, but we've got them scheduled every weekend. And now Pee Wee football will be start playing on Saturdays. We had Jamboree last Saturday. We've seen a lot of excited parents, a lot of excited kids. You know, everybody kind of gets a little edgy when football season starts. They're all excited about it, and especially when you have a little kid playing, you know, you get really excited about it. So our first game is a home game this Saturday at we'll be playing at Plainview Stadium. And y'all come out and support them. And
was they excited about the bear night?
Yeah, they were excited. They got to go out there. everybody in Plainview that has to do with fall sports, I think, went out there. The band went out there, cheerleaders. They started out calling the varsity out, and they started on one goal line. And they went through all the high school, junior varsity teams, and seventh and eighth grade. And then they called out the Pee Wee teams. So they were all lined up on the field at the same time, stretched the whole length of the field. And when they got through, Coach Ledbetter called them all out there, and they got together, and they chanted, and they broke all together. Pee Wee's involved in that. They were just really excited. Had a great night. Everything's going well. The pool's still going. We're still having parties there all the time.
How long will you be running it?
We're having parties till the end of August, and then we're gonna shut it down. I mean, the pool's still gonna be running, but we don't have any more. We're still having a few problems with the splash pad, but we're watching it and running. We run it on manual. And I've discussed it with people over there, and it's a problem from somebody in Ohio or something. But anyway, working on that problem, and we've got it running manually in the meantime until we get it automatic. So everything's going well. Fill the rooms, park system.
Appreciate it, Sam.
Thank you. Ms. Lund?
Well, I'd just like to personally thank each one of you, Bijan, Brandon, Ricky, Derek, and Roger, for personally sponsoring a hole for the air golf tournament. It was a big success. Maybe Sandy will tell you more about it. But we thank you for your support financially and being there with us Saturday. Brandon and Roger was. I know you were out of town. But anyway, we do thank you. And now I'm gonna switch hats and go to the Civitan. We are in the process of revitalizing the Civitan Club. It was to the point of closing, which it's the oldest club that Rainsville has. So we didn't want to see it close because it does a lot of good in the community. So you'll probably be getting a letter within the next few weeks telling you about the revitalization and wanting to get your support and hopefully get new members in. So just be watching for that. And we're even considering changing the time of the meeting so that we can get more people involved in it. Maybe if they can't come at lunch, they can come after work. So there's going to be a lot of changes to the club, and I hope you will support us as like you have the chamber. Thank you.
Thank you.
I just wanted to say that our golf tournament was a great success. Sandy and I really, really worked hard, and we had actually a record number of teams. We had 20 teams registered to play, and because we always have a couple of no-shows, and we did. So we had 18 teams play Saturday. Thank goodness it didn't rain. We had an awesome day, and we will. I don't have all the numbers yet because we have a couple outstanding invoices and a couple of incomes not in yet, but we will exceed our $15,000 from last year.
I was sick, so I was out of time. We didn't get a shirt.
That's what y'all get for not coming.
That's
right. I got one.
I'm telling you, it was an absolutely beautiful day to be outside. It was overcast, and it wasn't so hot, and it never did rain.
This first one I missed.
It was great.
I know, we missed you, Derek. And again, we do appreciate the city support with that. Thank you very much.
I've been in trouble if I win. It's my 10th anniversary.
So. Yeah, you would have been in the doghouse for sure. One thing I wanted to mention too, after meeting with Roger for a couple of moments, the Plainview Band is going to Gatlinburg for a Christmas parade. So our Christmas parade has to be rescheduled this year. Whether or not it'll stay that way, I do not know. But this year it will be the first Saturday in December, which will be December the 1st.
December
1st. At 12 o'clock.
At 12 o'clock.
That's the band.
Mm-hmm. No, that'll be our
the
Christmas.
Band, yeah, that yes. will be
but
our.
They'll still be able to come, though.
Yeah, they'll be able to come to it.
Yes.
They're going to Gatlinburg?
They're going to Gatlinburg the second Saturday for a parade, which we normally have ours.
Oh.
So we're backing ours up one Saturday and having it at 12 o'clock because that's the SEC game day, so we're moving it to 12 o'clock.
Yeah, no one can
so
the SEC
is not to be there.
Hey, are we going to still do the...
Well, that's what I was going to say, the Tom Bella Center.
Yeah.
When Roger and I spoke, if the Tom Bella Center wants to do their open house, we need to do it from like 10 to 11:30 or something like that to give them all the
chance. It was a big success last year, first time.
Yes, it was a huge success.
I think
we need to do it again. Sign call too.
Right. One other thing I wanted to mention, I know it's kind of a little bit ahead of time, but I looked at my calendar day, and Halloween's on Wednesday this year. So y'all might want to give consideration to when you would like to do trunk or treat in the park this year. So just FYI.
Last minute, last time.
Yeah, okay.
So we're gonna get jumped on.
We'll try to make a decision on that by the next week.
No, I just want you to be aware that it is on Wednesday this year. Pardon?
We actually talked about that at the golf tournament.
Right, we did, yes, okay. All right, thank you.
I know you wasn't there, Greg.
Well, I know y'all don't ever hear it, but I really appreciate the job y'all do.
Thank you so much.
I know y'all put a lot of work into it, and y'all do an outstanding job.
We appreciate that.
Very, very vital to the city of Rainsville.
We hope so.
And the small business.
Y'all can't make it without us, right?
Appreciate y'all.
Thank you.
Okay, it's 5 o'clock, we'll go ahead and get started. Marshall?
Here.
Eric?
Here.
Ricky?
Here.
Larry?
Here.
Lee John?
Yeah.
Make a motion, we accept the minutes as presented.
Okay, that one.
I take exception that on those minutes, we didn't vote on the law, did we? Because Lee John said we voted on it.
No, nobody voted on the law, Marshall, for the last council meeting.
I was just making sure it wasn't the minutes, and I missed it. Okay.
Did you read them?
Yeah, I read them.
Okay.
I just made sure it wasn't in there, I missed it.
It wasn't in there, was it?
I'll second.
Okay. All right, we have a motion and a second to approve the minutes as presented by the clerk. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Okay. I'll start off with the ADECA grant and go ahead and go forward with that to give me permission to sign that contract for that grant for the wastewater treatment pumping station on Highway 35 and Scott Street.
I'll make that motion. I'll second it.
I have a motion and a second to approve me to sign the contract with ADECA and move forward with Jet Pep doing the work.
What's the number on that?
389-412-73.
Let the record reflect that.
Yeah, okay. All right, all in favor, say aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Ayes have it. Okay.
Appreciate you working hard on that too, Mayor. I know it's a lot of behind the scenes deal, and you put a lot of time in up here at City Hall. We appreciate that.
Well, we have a lot of meetings about anything pertaining to the state like that, you know, through the DECA or whatever. You have a lot of meetings, and it does take some time. But, hey, it's worth it when you can get that, you know, that kind of money, you know. I know it's not free, because Rodney said, well, good one. Hey, one spot on the left. Okay, Marshall.
All I've got to say is, people think y'all try to paint me as an obstructionist, but we're $322,000 in the rate of 75%, and that was 75% of the year in the, that's in the road department. Is that not where that money came from? I just want everybody to know it. That's $322,000 in the red. That was 75% of the year reporting. That's our in-house projected. That's what we spent. I just want everybody to know that.
It's good. Well, I'm proud you make everybody aware of that, Councilman. Because I'm on the other hand of that. I'm going to defend that. Because I'm not going to let people run through the roads and them culverts falling in and the roads.
Where that money come from?
So, you know, it goes back to what I said before. We have different views on that, and my view is to protect the people that drives up down the street.
Right.
So we have different opinions of that. You have entitled yours, and I'm entitled to mine.
No, that's fine. Well, that's what I'm voting on. That's all that stuff.
On the defense side of that right there, I mean, just trying to clear it up a little bit. There's, as long as I've been on the council, we have never really budgeted paving. Paving is just something that we're trying to come up with some money during the year to try to pay. And so this year, that $300-something thousand is what we were able to come up with to try to do some paving, and we did. And so
yeah, it's just a lot of money.
Yeah,
it's
and
just
and,
a lot of
but
pages. We projected 400-something.
If you don't budget, the paving, and you pave, then you're going to be in the lead.
Do you budget?
But you had the money to pave it because it was there.
Do you budget? Because I budget.
Well, I try to budget, and I don't.
I mean, do you? It's just a line item budget. It's just like me.
I understand.
I have so much money I'm gonna spend in the month or the year on my chemicals, and you know.
And you
with
go
this
over
trip,
a lot. Is that how it is?
Sometimes you do, yeah. Because it just depends on what you get in.
And then what happens when you get to the end?
Well,
you're half a million dollars over budget.
You just got.
What happens eventually?
Well, you just gotta make make sure you get across the guy.
He just quit killing everybody.
We had the money to do it.
We had, it's just,
but it wasn't budgeted, it was because it was not in there in the budget.
So next budget.
Okay, so next year, we won't do any of that. We'll just do like you want to do, so.
We're just gonna keep it tight next year.
Yeah. Y'all just keep it tight, just for you.
Okay, I'll bear with that.
We're staying.
Good?
Yeah, I'm good.
I still think we're good on our numbers anyways, around the city, we're still good, so.
Do you have anything?
I don't have anything, I just wanna thank the fire department, police department, y'all are doing an outstanding job. Appreciate y'all training the new guys, chief, and I know I've heard nothing but good things from some of the other firemen. So what y'all are doing, we appreciate it, and also assistant chief Whitman back there, keep us updated on Luke, let us know how he's doing.
Yes, sir.
How's our animal control guy?
Doing well.
He's still good, okay. I've been to bring that up further and there. Make sure, I ain't really got anything to spend that, it's gonna be a lot.
Rick?
I do, Mayor. I'm gonna spend $3,400 to do that paving down there.
Mm-hmm.
And I know the people on Parker, and the Everett, Maple, and all down through there will greatly appreciate that, that we're trying to keep the roads structured in back to where they're safe.
Mm-hmm.
So with that being said, I'm gonna make a motion that we do $3,400 on paving that back across that culvert.
I second his motion.
All right, we have a motion and a second. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed?
No.
Okay.
I mean, I think it needs it, but the fact that it is, we're over budget.
Yes, sir. Mayor, by listening to Tina talk about some of the issues and stuff, if we've been doing 500 in the past, I'd like to see if we could go ahead and work that in there, advertise a budget to do $750 for adding some grass.
Okay.
I second the motion.
All right, we have a motion and a second to do $750 for Addicts of Christ. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
All opposed?
That's all I have, man.
Okay. Bijan.
Matt, I want to make a motion to hire our engineer, Sam Phillip, to submit the permit to state for easement or street, actually, to Highway 75. For entrance to our garage, and so I'll make a motion to let him do the paperwork.
Okay.
I second his motion, Mayor.
I have a motion and a second to get Sam Phillips to do some paperwork on street on Highway 75 South. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Okay.
And also, I want to bring this up tonight that we don't have to work on it. I want to change the resolution of 2014, that's $750 to increase, and we need to talk about this, how much we want to increase it to. And also, if you got a project that you want to do and other councils agree with it, their money part goes towards that project. The clause needs to be in there. So that way it won't be any confusion on the next project that we need to do. Like Councilman Brown say, if he's got a truck that is tore up and it's more than $750, he don't need to be calling everybody to get that truck fixed, because when he can fix it and put it back on the road. If it's $300, $400, $500, you don't have to come to council and prove that. Let them go ahead and fix it, then we'll work on the way. So if we need to change the resolution, I'll bring that up now to change the resolution.
Well, you don't really need to bring it up to change resolutions until you get a resolution that you want to work off of. So let's work on it this week. Yeah, let's work on it this week, and then we'll work. Then we'll bring it up the next week.
What would be the fair price to put it on it?
I don't know.
Just, I think it needs to be double, from $750 to $50.
What's going to put these other people that's sitting here on this table in a quandary since they've always passed last time?
Who wrote down it last time?
We don't care who.
I wish you used words you even knew what meant for a change.
Quandary means it's gonna put them in kind of, you know, a
change situation. You're the only person that brings constant controversy sitting up here anyway, so it don't matter. We're good with it.
Well, I'll explain what it means. It means you and the mayor voted for it last time.
We sure did.
Now you're gonna back up and change.
You ever changed your mind on something?
Let me tell you this. Down through the years that I've been on the council, every different term, a lot of the terms have been, that right there has been changed, because it used to be like $500, and it used to be like $250. It's $250 and $500 at times.
No, we're the only group that's ever changed anything.
Yeah.
Maybe we got the only group.
It has been changed.
Y'all can write down why you like it, y'all. Y'all don't do whatever. Y'all got the number.
Well, then why are you worried about it?
Okay, let's move forward with some bill paying.
I make a motion to pay the monthly bills.
I second this motion.
We got a motion and a second to pay the monthly bills.
I'll make a motion.
All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed?
I'll make a motion to adjourn.
Alright, we have a motion and a second to adjourn. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed?
Are you able to open that email from him? Yeah, but I finally got it. And I like it.